love photography and I love taking pictures. I've been doing it since I was 6 years old. And there's so many interesting images that you can capture when you're on these fantasy movies. And you know, Gore and Derek Kowalski, they're such brilliant visualists. And then when they set up those shots, they do you a big favor because they have all this beautiful scenery for you to work with and beautiful angles and beautiful light. So it's nice for you to be able to piggyback on them and capture some of these wonderful images that they're creating. What we did this time is we took a vessel, an actual, you know, ship, a tugboat, basically, and built a ship around it. Built the Black Pearl right around this other ship. So it was seagoing, it traveled from Alabama to the Caribbean on its own. It's still with us. It's not, in the first movie we had, you know, portions of ships that were on barges, but never really an entire ship that could function on its own. And this time we did that. Jack finds out that he's being chased by this character called the Kraken, which is a sea creature. So the minute he hears that the Kraken's after him, he finds an island. Unfortunately, the island that he picks is inhabited with cannibals. And Jack, being the clever sort of fellow that he is, convinces them that he's a spirit and a god, and becomes their king. But what the cannibals decide, since they all want to have that spirit and that godlike quality that Jack has, they're going to eat their king. And so they're getting ready to roast him.
Samuel, please.
You got to work with great actors. I mean, you know, Johnny, everybody wants to work with him. He's one of our greatest actors. He loves his character. His character is so clever and so smart and so much fun and heroic in a kind of underhanded way. He loves playing his character, and he keeps, you know, adding things to the character, whether it's his wardrobe or the stunts he pulls in the movie or how he manipulates things. You know, Orlando's is a hardworking actor. He works at his craft. He's done an enormous amount of work between the first Pirates and the second Pirates. He's worked with Ridley Scott. You know, he's worked with some terrific directors. And again, he's embellished his craft, gotten better. And when you start out when you're really good, you know, you only can go up. He keeps going up. You know, Keira is an extraordinary actress, and you could see that when we first cast her. I think she's only 18 years old or 17 years old when we cast her in the first Pirates thing. And you watch how her character ages and grows from being 18 in the first movie, and now she's almost 21. You just see how she's matured, and the character's matured. So we use that to our advantage, and you see how more interesting she can embellish the characters. You know, the skills that she had in the first movie have even heightened more in through the amount of work that she's done. She's this very young girl with this amazing gift of being not only beautiful, but a terrific actress. Jack Davenport's a wonderful actor, and you know, it's just great to bring him back. And that's why he's back, to be honest with you. He's just such a superb actor. We wanted him to be part of the party, because he's fun to work with, and he created a great character. And this character is even more embellished and more rich. And so he's a major player in both 2 and 3. And you have a director, Gore, Verbinski, who can take all these talents that he has chosen to work with and then amp them to another level. That's certainly a gift that I wish I had. But he, you know, he is the consummate general. And what's interesting about Gore is that when he's on the set, he's driven to do good work. He drives his crew, but he never raises his voice. He's always in control and does everything in a very nice, mild manner. Yet he gets the work that he has to get done in a day. I keep mementos. I put a book together of every movie and have it bound of all the photographs that I take.